The topic given to me is cardiovascular risk management challenges and solutions. The problem with cardiovascular disease is that we have known the conventional risk factors for a long, long time, more than two or three decades. But however, we have not been able to get the results which we wanted to get. Where it will come? Okay. So we have not been able, mainly because of the because patients are not amenable to lifestyle modifications. So there are many challenges, more challenges than solutions. In India, because of rapid urbanization and attendant reduced physical activity and changing dietary pattern, there have been exponential increase in the number of cardiovascular disease cases. And unfortunately, compared to the West, where more than 90% of the MI cases occur after 50 years of age, more than 50% of the cases in Indian men occur at less than 50 years of age. We all see day in and day out young MIs, and it is very heartening to see young patients suffering. So as this was predicted earlier on, that we have the, in red as shown, non-communicable diseases are ever increasing. And this is 2010 data from our country by WHO showing 24 lakh people died in that year because of cardiovascular disease, which is not a small number. So what is this risk? As an individual, one starts with a low risk, that is no risk factors, and as the age advances and with lifestyle changes, one accumulates multiple risk factors. And not in all, but in most patients, it will result in subclinical atherosclerosis. Many patients have subclinical atherosclerosis, though many will remain asymptomatic till late in the life, many will develop clinical atherosclerotic manifestations, typically in the form of angina or myocardial infarction and death. So this cardiometabolic risk is defined as situation where probability of developing atherosclerosis is very high because of constellation of multiple risk factors. Not only this increased constellation of risk factors, this also results in procoagulant state and low-grade inflammation in the vascular system. So the central to all this controversy, all this problem is the central obesity or abdominal obesity, which give rise to, which is the harbinger of all other problems. So central obesity in concurrence with high blood pressure and lipid abnormalities, it results in cardiovascular disease, and it also results in diabetes, which further, if one becomes diabetic, further increases chances of developing cardiovascular disease. So these risk factors, in short, are obesity, high triglyceride levels, low HDL levels, hypertension, and impaired glucose tolerance. And this data from our country shows that as the age advances, these risk factors are increasing. And typically, if you see in the golden bar, up to 60% people have abdominal obesity. And mind you that our figures are, it is 40 inch in, more than 40 inch in men in Western countries, but it has been studied very well that we at even less than that, that is at 35 inches, we have same effects as 40 inch in a Western person. That is, if you are obese, it is much more harmful. And it has been shown that constellation as a risk factor increases cardiovascular events and mortality in time and again. So what do guidelines say? Guidelines say that you can calculate the score, framework score. We are all aware of it. One can calculate it on one's smartphone. And as the number of risk factor increases, as in this case, in the end, in D, the with almost all the risk factors being present, risk is very high, 37% over 10 years. But the problem is, a problem does not end over here. We have known this framework score for a long, long time. The problem is that this large data from America, this shows that 76% of the studied population was low risk. But still, if you show see the blue bar, it is, they still, conventionally they are low risk, but still they develop, a lot of them develop cardiovascular events. This bar should have been smaller, but it is considerably bigger. Here comes the concept of polypill, that patients who at above the age of 55 years, there have been studies and sort of estimates that everybody above the age of 55 years in Western population, if they are given polypill, then cardiovascular disease can be cut down by as high as 80%. And as we know, these risk factors, as I discussed, are this is only moderately accurate. And various risk factors, other coronary calcium score, etc., have been added to it, but there is no consensus. So as I said, the primary aspect is obesity. But nobody will listen to you if you tell. This is important because abdominal obesity, the fat, the retroperitoneal fat, this is highly metabolic active compared to the fat at the in the other areas, and it produces so much of chemokines as shown in the red bar. We know that hypertension, if we reduce the blood pressure by 10 millimeter of mercury systolic, risk reduces by 25%, and stroke reduces more. We know LDL reduction results in better outcomes. And we also know, as shown in the primary prevention study, that is Jupiter trial, where patients with normal or average LDL levels were given on the basis of inflammatory marker, that is CRP. If their inflammation is tackled as the primary thing, we have 50% reduction in mortality. So what is the problem? The problem, if we look carefully in this heart protection study, in around 20,000 patients given 40 milligrams of simvastatin, we see that there is about 25% relative risk reduction over 5 years. That is only 1% absolute risk reduction every year. Despite being on statin, as shown by the red line, still, if the patient is religious, taking high dose of statin, even then 20% will still develop event if they have high risk factors to begin with. So we have to, the why this is important is that you have to start much earlier. And importantly, many patients, up to 50% of patients with normal cholesterol level develop MI. And this is Indian data, this year data, which shows in yellow, 50% of women and 70% of men have undetected hypertension, as was done on. Even clinicians, even not only patients are at fault, not they're not taking drugs. Clinicians, about 40% patients do not have their BP controlled, because patient comes to the doctor, he sees BP 146 by 96, he says, chalne chalta hai, wo chalne dete hain, agli baar dekhenge. Similarly, cholesterol values, you see post-MI patient, LDL 88, 90, you do not do anything. So what do you have to do? We have to follow the guidelines to decrease the risk. But if you follow the guidelines, you prescribe large number of drugs. And today, cardiology practice is a practice of polypharmacy. Patients are on 7, 8, 6, 7, 8 drugs. And as it has been shown time and again, multiple studies are there. This last study of 85,000 patients, it shows that as the number of pills increase, then patients stop. Then only 55% adherence to 4-drug regimen. Patients are, this is an important study in the sense that patients have been implanted with drug-eluting stent, and at 1 month, only 2/3 patients continue to take their drugs, that is clopidogrel, this thing, and 1/3 patient knows that he has been stented, he knows he is high risk, and still they stop. And if you see 5-year data, this is from rich and poor countries, a combination study, and you see the figures are less than 25%. Over 5 years of patients who has had event, and in some of the countries in this study, it was as low as 3%. And typically, it has been seen that doctors write costly drugs because of the pharmaceutical pressure, like will not write metoprolol, but write metoprolol extended, which is almost 10 times costlier. And this is European and German study, which shows from 12 countries, and it shows that even doctors do not follow guidelines adequately. And does this affect if the patient starts medicine? Yes. There is markedly increased, as seen in the lower dotted line, that survival markedly decreases. And this is an interesting estimate from the ESCOT study, which was a major hypertension and lipid drug trial, which shows that if patient takes more than 80% of the drugs, then a lot of myocardial infarction and strokes can be prevented. And what is the solution? Doctors are not following because everything is very complex. So this there is a, it's a marriage of adherence and risk reduction. That is polycap. by Cadila Pharmaceuticals containing three anti-hepatitis C drugs, a diuretic, beta blocker, and ACE inhibitor, along with simvastatin and aspirin. And WHO has said, and various authorities have said, that you do not have to show the result that it decreases mortality when the individual components have shown it that the product decreases mortality. So what they have done is it was published in the prestigious American Journal of Cardiovascular Drugs. They have shown that individual components, the bioavailability remains same. So if somebody asks us, their polycaps type of drugs are available in market by various companies, I will say that you cannot use them unless they have shown that their product have shown bioequivalence. Only the proven drug has to be shown to be bioequivalent. Empire study shows that adherence increases up to 3 times if polycap is used, and this was first study published in 2009 in Lancet. This was a proof of concept study where they showed that the efficacy of the individual component remains as it is. They had shown bioequivalence in the lab, and now this is clinical counterpart, that efficacy remains absolutely same when capsule is given compared to individual components, as far as blood pressure reduction is concerned, as far as LDL reduction is concerned, or as far as 11 dehydrothrombopoietin B2 levels in urine are concerned, which tell about the aspirin efficacy activity. Now the concept has been increased further. This was primary prevention study, first study. Now TIPS 2, which is secondary prevention, has been published, and it is secondary prevention study, means stable CAD patients or high-risk diabetic patients. And it has shown that there were two groups, single capsule and two capsules, which are highly effective. So coming over to this, there are multiple trials ongoing. This is to sum up last two slides. There are multiple issues in primary prevention. I have summed up myself that we cannot identify high-risk individuals. We know that. So many patients with no risk factors, or only one or two risk factors present with ACS often in our setting. Hence, our present knowledge of risk assessment is at best primitive. If I ask whether I can develop MI in less 5 years, it's difficult to tell adequately. So what to do? We know treatment with individual components is effective. So it has been proposed, as I said, that everybody, like we give fortified salt or something like that, everybody be given this thing. Problem adherence. Patients who are on drugs, they do not take this thing. So those can be given. So polypill is already a reality and has a great future. And even guidelines say, this last line in underlined in blue color, polycap formulation could conveniently reduce multiple risk factors. Thank you.